Welcome to 558 Parkside Tech, where we talk about tech's past, present, and the future of tech. I'm your tech plug, Mike, and today I'm talking about Azure storage, spinning up storage in Azure. So all you 558ers, future tech creators, stay tuned right after this. 558 Parkside Tech, in effect, 558 Parkside Tech, in effect, 558 Parkside Tech, in effect, Parkside. Today we're talking about the Azure storage account. Not a very sexy subject, but a very necessary subject if you want to back up data or you want to use queues or blob storage to store data. Before I go into Azure, I want to talk about two things. Now, there are more redundant storages, but I'm going to talk about these two in particular because 9 times out of 10, if you're a developer and you're spinning up storage, you're going to be either doing local redundant storage or geo-redundant storage. Now, if you're doing local redundant storage, what you're really saying is that my primary disk has 3 backups within the same data center. That's important you understand that. So whatever region you're in, whether it be east, west, you're going to create 3 backups just in case your main one is corrupted. Now, when you say GRS or geo-redundant storage, what's going to happen is not only that local redundant storage has been created, so you still have 3 in that main region, but you also have in a totally separate region, 3 built right there for you as well. Now that additional region is for read only. And I wanted you to understand that. So when you're choosing LRS or you're choosing GRS, it's important that you understand that. Now where we're going to be going to do this work is the Azure portal. As well as I wanted to introduce you to the Azure pricing calculator. That's important. Now I'm bringing this up to those that don't really do anything in the cloud, that they're new to the cloud. A lot of the mainframe folks are new to the cloud and they're used to doing length times number of records and coming up with this number of bytes, and then they call a DBA or whoever to store their data, but they don't really know what it's going to cost them from a cost perspective when they talk to their manager. But now with the Azure pricing calculator, when you're in the cloud, before you do anything, you know what it's going to cost you monthly to store this data. So let's go to that. So now let's talk about the Azure calculator. So if I was to go into like a Bing search, Google search, whatever, and I type in Azure calculator pricing, all right, then let's say I scroll down and I click here, I get a screen like this. So now we know we were talking about storage accounts. So what I'm going to do here is click Azure storage account. And as I scroll down, you will see for Azure storage account, it kind of pre-filled some things in for me. All right. Now, in this case, as you know, I was going to do blob storage. It's standard. We've already talked about LRS, but there are many more. And I talked about GRS, but there are many more. I'm only talking about those two because if you're a developer and you're spinning up things on your own so that you can learn, these are the two you want to stick with. And I'm thinking you're going to do more LRS anyway, local redundant storage. It talks about the storage type, general purpose too. It's saying it's a hot tier. I explained to you that hot tier means it's going to be used on a regular basis, access on a regular basis versus cold tier or archive, okay, or cool. All right, we talked about a flat namespace. I said I was going to put it in the West US 2 region. Now, as I scroll down, it says here that pay as you go, you can see that. And it asked me about write operations, read operations, data retrieval, and so forth. Now, it's I kind of pre-plugged this in, but here I'm putting, I had 1,000 from previous, so it's showing me 1,000. So let's say I change this to, I'm gonna do 2,000 writes. And I decide I wanna do, I don't know, 600 reads. Now, as you can see, it's starting to tally up on the right-hand side. So as I scroll down, it's saying for me, for what I've selected for this storage in the West, it's gonna cost me $125.80. Now, what you could do with this information, you can take this, all right? I had a few others here that I've done before, and you can export it. And you can export it and give it to whatever department you need to give it to that's going to pay for this storage. Or you can send it to your manager and say, hey, if we decide to do this, we decide to store this in the cloud, this is what it's going to cost us monthly. So there's no surprises. All right. And that's kind of pretty straightforward for how the Azure calculator works. There's a few of them I have out here. You can do a number of them and keep them out here, or you can actually delete them if you like. You can go through and you can delete them and go forth, or save them all for, let's say, various storage devices you're going to create for different projects. All right, that's all I've got for the Azure calculator. It's pretty straightforward. As you can see now, I'm in the Azure portal. Now what we want to do, as we previously mentioned, is create an Azure storage account. Now, so I'm going to hit accounts. All right, now I could do it two places. I could either say create Azure storage account here, or I can go here. You choose which one you want, whichever makes it easier for you. So I'm going to hit create here. All right. Now, once I get here, you see there's a couple of things that are pre-filled in. The reason why, if you followed me in the past, it's kind of clear that I've created a resource group. All right. Now, under what a resource group is whenever you're doing a project, you can kind of roll up all your databases, everything under a resource group. That way, when you're done with it, it's a nice clear delineation that when you delete the resource group, all the items that are associated with it gets deleted. So we're going to create this Azure storage account under this resource group. So here I'm going to have to fill in what is the Azure account name. All right. So what I'm going to call it is Azure Storage EX1. All right. As you notice, I use all lowercase. You have to do it lowercase. It won't do camel case, as I explained when I was talking about C sharp. You have to lose lowercase. Now here it's asking me, where do you want to put this resource? It says it ought to kind of pre-filled West US, but you can see here, you can pick anywhere you want to store it. Now, depending on where you're locating your storage account, your applications and everything, and where you want to put it might cost you a little bit more. But in this case, I'm going to stick with West US. All right. Now here is the primary service. Do I want to create Azure files, other tables and queues? But in this case, I just want to create an Azure blob storage because I want to back up my data. Now it says kind of performance do you want? I'm just going to stick with standard. Now here's what I talked about earlier. Instead of geo redundant, I'm going to go ahead and do local. All right. This is just a little test storage I want to create because I want to write something that's personal. All right. It's not something that's for a company. It's just something I want to create. All right. So I'm going to hit the review and create. Now, if you notice, it skipped past all these others. We were in basic when I was creating this. It skipped past all the others, just kind of created some basics for us. And this is what it created. Now, what I want to do, instead of hitting create, I'm going to go back and we're going to take a look at some things. Like, for example, whenever you see the access tier is hot, that means something I want to get to on a regular basis. There's actually cold and hot. Cold is something you're not going to want to get to on a regular basis. Let's say you're backing up something, you don't really want to get to it. It's just something you want to just store in case something happens to your main data. All right. But I'm going to go backwards and look at a couple of things. It talks about encryption. It talks about data protection, that if you delete something, a number of days is going to retain it and so forth. It talks about networking. It also talks about some of the other things like the REST API operations and so forth. I wanted you to see that because it immediately, because you're creating it, it jumps over to review it. It already pre-fills and all these other things, okay? So now I'm just going to go ahead and say create. This is very straightforward and quick. This is not something you should have a problem with. As you can see, it's initializing the deployment. It's putting it under that resource group that I showed you previously. NOC VA test 1, been deployed, deployment is in process. And then at this, once it's finished, we'll have a storage account. And then I can go ahead and put things in the storage account, save things or whatever I want to do. Now this has nothing to do with databases. I will show you that in another video, how to spin up, because most developers, if you're writing code, you're trying to connect to a database, I will spin up a SQL Server database and I'll put it under the same resource, all right? So now it allows me to go to resource, all right? And this is the resource already have been created. So that's how simple it is to create an Azure storage account. As you can see, Azure offers different types of storage accounts for many different use cases. Everything from long-term or active databases to data that has to be archived. So don't be afraid to set up your own storage account and kind of play around and back up data on your own. If this video was any benefit to you, please hit the like button and subscribe. Also hit the notification bell for any of my latest videos that'll be coming out. That way you don't miss anything and you continue on your journey and your learning. Well, that's all I got. As always, be better than your best excuse and learn tech. Life is like a 2-minute drill, so you have to continue to make the right plays. All right, that's all I got. Your Tech Plug Mike. Peace.
Yeah, 558 Park Site Tech in effect. That tech 558 Park Site Tech in effect. Tap in the future. Let me introduce ya. 558 Park Site Tech, about to school ya. 558 Park Site Tech in effect. That tech 558 Park Site Tech in effect. That tech 558 Park Site Tech in effect.
Park, son.